cuts on Mulgrew's wrist ran lengthwise along the radial artery, common for this type of suicide, but I did find rope indentations on the epidermis, suggesting that he was tied to his chair prior to being cut. So, once again, Gibbs was right. The suicide was staged. I also found tentacles growing out of the victim's forehead.
What?
You still bothered about last night?
I just can't believe that Bishop went out with him. He's my girlfriend's son. I mean, isn't that weird? Or is it just me?
No, it's not just you. I mean, this is definitely weird.
What is he trying to do? Is he trying to torpedo my relationship with Elena?
Okay, all right. What you are feeling right now, this is exactly why we have that rule. You never date a coworker.
Okay, first of all, I didn't date her. I didn't want to date with her.
All right, fine. You never double date with a coworker, all right? The point is, the line between personal and professional can sometimes be tricky. After Tony and Ziva, I mean, we all learned that lesson big time.
Tony and Ziva. What went wrong there?
Well, it started off great. I mean, they're constantly flirting. Constantly fighting, too, but, yeah, I knew something was going on there.
You?
Yeah, I got sort of a sixth sense about these sort of things. I can spot an office romance from a mile away. Take you and Bishop, for instance. Mm-hmm. I don't see anything, there's nothing there, zero chemistry.
I can't believe he's still mad at me.
No, Torres. He just needs to cool off a little bit.
Yeah, but last year he deleted texts from my phone, interfered with my dating life, and now he's giving me the cold shoulder? I mean, it just pisses me off.
Well, maybe that's not the only reason you're upset.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm just saying maybe you went out with Richard just to tweak Torres a little bit, and now you feel bad about it.
Okay, whose side are you on anyway?
I'm on whichever side gets me out of this conversation.
Torres, our guy. Excuse me, Patrick Norian?
Yes.
NCIS, Special Agent Bishop and McGee. We have a couple of questions about your former contractor, Daniel Mulgrew.
Is this gonna take long? I was trying to duck out to catch the Caps play. I never miss a game.
No, we'll be quick. You were his access manager?
That's right.
You usually hire people with criminal records? You're aware he had priors?
Are you kidding? That's why we hired him. We often employ hackers to find flaws in our systems.
Why did Daniel Mulgrew stop working here?
Have you ever heard of Love, Int?
No.
It's when people in intelligence illegally use surveillance to spy on love interests, and it was coined here at the NSA.
Unfortunately.
So was Mulgrew guilty of that?
There were multiple accusations. Taking cameras to spy on female co-workers, I mean, really creepy stuff.
Well, we never saw that on his rap sheet.
We never had enough to charge him. It got so toxic around here, I had to let him go. Haven't heard from him since.
Do you have an internal report we could read?
Yeah, of course. I'll send it over. You got a card?
Yeah. In fact, I do.
Casey, hey.
Are you still at the NSA?
I am. What's up?
I was able to trace the emails between Mulgrew and his boss. It wasn't easy. They were blocked with the mother of all encryptions. Want to know why? Because the emails came from the NSA. Some guy named Patrick Norian.
You don't say. Mr. Norian!